The Maselli Group presents seminars and workshops, advanced presentation skills for financial professionals, with Frank Maselli, financial industry expert and author of the best-selling book, Seminars, The Emotional Dynamic. Episode 15, Enthusiasm.
Hi, welcome back. I'm Frank Maselli. We are now into episode 15, my favorite one, Enthusiasm. Enthusiasm is the most prized trait amongst professional speakers. I don't think you can even begin to do workshops or seminars without professional level enthusiasm. So let's talk about this. Let's spend a little time on it. It's actually quite simple. I'm not going to drill down as deep as I would really like to, because some of this is fairly complicated and it gets into dramatic staging and technique and movement and stuff. But I want to give you some ideas and some strategies that you can use to display enthusiasm, to show the audience that you have that passion and energy. It's not what you say, it's how you say it. You've heard this expression about a million times, but it's absolutely true. You could read to that audience from the phone book and you could still generate relationships if you did it with professional enthusiasm. So let's get into this. Let's have some fun. Passion and conviction. Those are the two elements the audience is picking up on. These are the things they want from you, not facts and statistics and quotes and stories and fancy graphs and charts. All of that is good, and all of that has a place in a workshop. I'm not discounting the value of that. But ultimately, what the audience is going to buy into is your passion and conviction. And this is where you get a chance to display that energy. Energy is the other one. It takes energy to do a workshop. It takes a commitment. It takes a performer's focus and intensity. Now, this is interesting. I go back to my theater days. I've done a lot of theater in my life, stage theater. And no matter how you felt, and there's an old theater saying that goes with this, I mean, you could feel like the cat dragged you in, okay? I mean, you're in trouble, you're sick, you're not feeling well. What's the old theater saying? The show must go on. And I've been in a bad way many, many times before a performance. And a professional performer pulls it together. I'll give you a real-world example. Those of you who follow theater or know anything about theater, it's interesting. There was a great show on Broadway a number of years ago called The Producers. It starred Matthew Broderick and Nathan Lane, one of the funniest shows ever invented by mankind. Hysterical, hysterical show. I promise you, I guarantee you that, oh, I don't know, around performance 600, Matthew and Nathan were sitting in the dressing room, and one of them turned to the other and said, "Do you believe we got to do this the 600th time? This is killing me. When are we going to get out of here?" I promise you, as human beings, they were exhausted, they were tired, they had played the roles for a long time. But then something interesting happens in the mind of a professional. A professional performer would have that laugh, they'd have that intimate moment, and then they would say, "But you know what? It's our 600th performance, but it's their first." And every night they went out there, and every night they gave 100%, which is all you can give, by the way, all right? They gave it all, they left it on the stage, and people went wild. That's the difference between a professional and an amateur. So, with that as the backdrop, the energy and commitment you need is essential. You need to make them feel the heat. You need to have the intensity that gets them excited. You just can't be warm yourself. That's great. You got to heat the audience up, or they're not going to do all the things that you want them to do. So you've got to be extra hot, basically. They're looking for leadership. What do I mean by this? I think the public wants to work with an advisor who's ready to take control. I don't want to work with a milquetoast, wimpy advisor. I want to work with somebody, you know, they've got some guts. They've got some, I'm trying to think of a clean word to say, and I can't think of anything. But the bottom line is they've got something to offer. They bring some intensity to the table. That's what I'm looking for. It also sends a message of success. When you can give that professional intensity, when you can deliver a powerful performance in front of the room, it sends a subliminal message that says you are a successful professional. All of these are great reasons. How do you do it? How do you do it? How do you display intensity? How do you display passion? Okay. Let me give you some simple techniques, okay? These are techniques. Now, I'm not going to get into the psychology of this. I'm not going to get into, you know, the presentation itself. You've got to have a presentation, hopefully, that lends itself to passion and enthusiasm. That's a given. But what can you do as a presenter, as a master speaker, to convey that message? Well, it starts with vocal variety. Hold that thought. We're going to cover that in detail. Dramatic techniques, movement, gestures, and use of language. These are the five main categories that I would classify as methods of displaying enthusiasm as a speaker. All right. Dramatic techniques, extremely complicated. I'm not going to go into detail on that. We talked in a very early episode, I think when we talked about the power opening, the use of silence as a dramatic technique. At this stage in your development, that's the only one I would really recommend. There are others, but I think let's keep it simple for the time being. Get comfortable with silence. Professional speakers use silence. Silence gives you a whole host of options, not the least of which is that sometimes it opens up an audience dynamic and it gets the audience involved. You may be silent, somebody may jump in and say something. Great opportunity for spontaneous humor if you're comfortable with it, but you have to be comfortable with silence to do that. So we'll leave the dramatic techniques on silence. It's the only one I want you to work on. Get used to silence, try it in the opening, it can be very useful. Movement and gestures. To the novice, that sounds like the same thing. Movement, gestures, same thing. No, movement is body. The whole body is moving. Stay with me. I'm going to wander very quickly, all right? The whole body moves. Now, listen, I am absolutely the worst at movement. I tend to move in a very simple pattern. I mean, look at me. I don't like to move in general, bottom line. So my movements will be very simple. I'm not the best example of movement. I know some speakers who are excellent at moving. They cover the whole room. I will tell you personally, I find that to be a little much. All right? I know speakers who are extremely dramatic. They will run over to people. They'll take their jackets off. They've got all kinds of little sticky things that they do. Fine. You know what? If it's your style, if it works for you, that's great. To me, it's too much. I don't do it. And I don't recommend it in a financial presentation. I mean, you know, this is not Cirque du Soleil. You're here to build relationships with prospective investors. I think you can be too big in that regard. Gestures, however, are smaller. Gestures are, I would classify them as arms, hands, facial expressions, and movements that don't necessarily involve, you know, wandering around in front of the room. I like gestures. I think gestures are important. Learning how to use great gestures is a wonderful thing. What's a great gesture? The closed fist, the intense fist move. Be careful with this. This was the old Bill Clinton, I feel your pain. You know, watch out. Watch politicians as an example sometimes of what not to do. They get stuck in a gesture and they use these all the time and it's difficult. Facial expressions. This is a Pandora's box of stuff that we could get into. The only thing I would suggest to you is look at yourself in a mirror or look at yourself on videotape. And I'll be honest with you. When I look at myself on videotape, it bothers the heck out of me. I mean, it takes tremendous effort for me to watch myself on video. Call it a personal thing. Call it whatever you want. I just have a real problem with the way I look on video. But I still do it. Because I'm a professional, and professionals watch game films. You understand what I mean? Professionals watch themselves. They know what they look like. They know what they sound like. They know how their movements are distracting or problematic. The one thing I would tell you with gestures and movement, at this stage, again, in your development, just guard against the annoying ones, the ones that distract from your message, the ones that undermine your credibility. You know, the body position where you're really timid, the old fig leaf. And this is covered in basic public speaking, and you'll go to Toastmasters, you'll learn this, you go to Dale Carnegie, you learn this stuff. So watch out for gestures that undermine. We can get into, you know, powerful gestures, strengthening gestures. One of my favorite gestures was the table slam. This is glass. I need to be careful. But one of the reasons to have tables in your event is so that you can do the table slam. You've got a powerful point to make. Boom, slam that table. And don't just tap it. I'm talking slam it. It's worth the pain. Oh, my God, wake up the whole audience. Very powerful. The one I really want to talk about here is my favorite one, and it's the easiest one to work on, and it's called vocal variety. Professional presenters know how to vary their voice. It's easy to learn. I'm going to cover it very quickly. It's simple and it's fun to practice. This is the interesting thing. And you can practice this entirely on your own. In fact, on your own is the only way to practice this, because otherwise you look very strange. Pace, pitch, tone, inflection, I'm sorry, pace, pitch, tone, and volume. Those are the four variables. We'll stick with those because they're easy. Let's go back to pace. Pace runs the gamut between fast and slow. Pace is speed. Pace is what speed are you talking at? Now, you may notice that I tend to talk pretty quick. My natural style is a fairly fast presentation. But occasionally, when I want to highlight something, when I want to focus you on something, when I want to drill down into something, I'll slow it down. Learn how to do that. Go through your presentation and ask yourself and practice, which can I do fast? What can I do slow? The worst thing is, what's the worst thing? The worst thing is doing everything at the same pace, and we're going to cover pace, pitch, tone, volume. Oh my God, I'm dead. I mean, you're putting people to sleep. It's the worst thing you can do. So learn how to vary the pace, mix it up, and I think that will help tremendously. And it's easy to do, and sometimes you can get very fast. Sometimes you can get to throwaway. Now, you have to practice that, but, you know, it's worth doing. And sometimes when you're getting serious, it's okay to slow things down. So learn the mixture somewhere in between. Pitch. Pitch is high or low. High, 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 very up there. I couldn't do it if I wanted to. And then get down low. Give you a classic example of a difference in pitch. You may remember a singer named Barry White. Barry White was a great soul singer. Barry White had a two-note range. Oh, baby, baby, I love you, baby, baby. It's like a half a step range. It worked for him. It was his idiom. It was very powerful. It was dynamic, and it worked in that tradition. But give you another one. Minnie Riperton. I don't think anybody remembers the name Minnie Riperton. Anybody here? No, I didn't think so. Minnie Riperton sang a song called Loving You. Loving you is easy because you're beautiful. Ah, she hit notes. I can't even begin to get there. She hit notes that only dogs could hear. She had a 5-octave range. Barry White, 2 notes. Minnie Riperton, 5 octaves. 5 octaves, and I think you know from music theory, an octave is 8 notes. It's a standard measure of music. Too much. I don't want you to have 5 octaves. You couldn't do it if you tried, all right? Give me 1 good octave range. Give me a simple 8-note range. Maybe stretch it to 16 if you're really good. What's an octave? Watch this. Remember the movie The Sound of Music? How many people have seen The Sound of Music? We all have. There's a great song in The Sound of Music, which I want you to practice. I want you to sit in your car on your drive to work, which is the only safe place without being ridiculed, and I want you to sing a song.
Doe, a deer, a female deer. Ray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself. A long, long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread. La, a note to follow. So, tea, a drink with jam and bread. That will bring us back to dough. Oh, oh, oh,
dough!
A deer, a female.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. What is that? That's an octave. Do, do, do. Practice that. It'll strengthen and stretch a little bit of your vocal range. Now, that is extremely basic stuff. I mean, that is absolutely voice 101, not even. If you want to get good at this, if you want to be a professional about this, you want to learn some voice technique. You want to study with a voice coach. You want to get some help. There is help on the internet. You can Google voice coaching in any town you live in. There is somebody there who can help you strengthen, give your voice endurance, give you support. A lot of different variables. But the key is this. Your voice is your instrument. As a professional presenter, this is what you've got. This is it. Learn how to use it and learn how to vary the pitch. Give me at least 1 octave. Practice that song in the car. You can't go wrong. Tone. What is tone? Tone is how you say certain things. What's the intensity behind what you're saying at that moment? It runs a gamut. It runs a range between what I call strident, you must do this. This is the only way. What I call Captain Kirk delivery. Spock, the Klingons are attacking. Every word is hit hard, intensity. Every word has that power. Now, good Lord, You can't do that, all right? I mean, you can't do the whole workshop like that. First, you'll blow yourself out. Second, they'll be leaving. They'll get up and leave after 5 minutes. An audience can't sustain that either. So you mix it, strident, intense, to casual. Relax. Throw it away. I mean, there are some, you know, not every word you say is manna from heaven, right? Give a few things, let it come out relaxed. No big deal. Volume, simple one, volume, shout to whisper. Do I shout in my events? Yes, I'm not going to do it today because the sound guy will kill me. But somewhere loud to soft. Is it okay to get soft? Absolutely. Sometimes when you want to say something really important, when you want the audience to really pay attention, you take it down. Not only do you slow it down, but you take it down soft and quiet. This answers another interesting question that some of you may have in your mind. Should I or should I not use a microphone? All right, two schools have thought about this. One says it depends on the size of the room. If you've got five people sitting in front of you, don't bother. A microphone is overkill at that point. But if you've got, let's say, 20, 25, 30 people, a microphone could be appropriate. And the benefit of the microphone is not just that you're louder, which could be good, especially, by the way, if you're doing a senior seminar. The seniors have trouble hearing, all right? I mean, it's a gross generalization, but it's often very true. So you will need a microphone to amplify and to be louder. But the benefit of the microphone to the speaker is that it gives you a wider range of vocal choices. It lets you whisper and still be heard. Now, you need to learn how to use a microphone, and I'm not going to get into this. It's way too advanced. What kind of microphone? As you can see, I like to use a lavalier mic. I don't think about it. It's set. I'm good to go. I tend to turn the volume down before I start because I can really get loud, and there's nothing worse than blowing out the audience with a loud portion. So learn to modulate, learn to control, learn your natural range of intensity, of volume, and then mix it up. The whole point to this entire discussion, all right, is not to recommend any one style. It's to recommend that you mix the styles. That's the key. A mixture of pace, pitch, tone, volume, a mixture is what keeps the audience engaged. It transmits a message that says, hey, this is a professional presenter here. This is not going to be a boring lecture. This is going to be intense. This is going to be fun. This is going to be focused. And you'll see, you know, early in the seminar, you'll see husband nudge wife in the back row. This guy's going to be good. Oh, my God. That's incredible. That's a marvelous moment that you anticipate and that you hope for when you're doing a workshop. So learn vocal variety. Practice in the mirror if you need to. Clean up your distracting gestures. Look at yourself on video, watch your game films, very, very important. I think it's useful to do that. Professionals watch films, learn how good you are, okay? How do you sound? The greatest friend you have, by the way, is a tiny little voice recorder. I carry an Olympus recorder wherever I go. Keep it right in your pocket and record every presentation you do. And I'll make you a deal. Those of you listening to this at home, watching this video, those of you in the room today, if you record your presentations, which I strongly urge you to do, send it to me and I will give you a free evaluation of your presentation. I will watch your video or I will listen to your audio and I will tell you how you sound. Now, I'll be nice if you want me to be nice. Tell me, Frank, take it easy on me and I won't cut you to shreds. Or tell me, Frank, beat me up. Help me get better, and I'll be as tough as you want me to be. And I'll do it for free. I don't give this away. It's usually $3,000. But if you're watching this, I'll help you with it. I'm anxious to do it. So think about it.